The old gentleman said one time that he wanted something short and sweet. Well, the preacher said, I don't know too much about short and sweet unless you're talking about a 16-year-old girl in the So, but I know we got some short and sweet folk in here tonight. We've been through it quite a bit today, and I'm sure that you'll run out of steam now. But I'm going to be talking for a few moments from the book of John, the fourth chapter.
All right.
I want to talk about a well, a woman, and a city. And John began this particular chapter. We learn that first off, this woman was a racist.
All right.
She said, why are you asking me for what? Don't you know that I was American and you were Jew, and we don't have no dealings with one another?
All right, all right.
But Jesus began to talk to her like most folk like to be talked to.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. You might not respect, you might not believe in what they respect, but show them respect for it.
All right, preacher.
Kind of take them down a trail that will lead them slow.
Uh-huh.
You can't give a person the whole Bible in one sitting.
All right.
But she had a race problem. But you know, Jesus looked at her and he thought to himself, well, it's not a race problem she got. She needs some salvation.
Come on, brother.
Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Went on to straighten her out about the Samaritans and the Jews.
Yes, sir.
And we also learned that she had a marriage problem.
All right.
Anytime you stood before a preacher five times and gone to court five times, you say I do five times, and you say I don't.
Come on, preacher.
And then Jesus looked at her and said, well, you went out of the getting married business. You forgot about the preacher and the church, and you just moved in and started shacking up.
Mm.
We think that's something new today.
No, no, no. No, no.
That was going on in Jesus' time.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He had to bring this to her knowledge.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Don't they have good things and they don't really grasp what they're doing?
All right, all right.
But Jesus explained to her that even the one you with now is still not your own.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
He's still in a bad fit.
Yeah.
And then we learned that she had a religious problem.
Mm-hmm.
She wasn't talking about how long her father had been worshiping
in the mountain. Yeah.
In that mountain. But
Jesus.
You remember earlier in the chapter, Jesus said, I must need go through Samaria.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
Had Jesus not gone to Samaria, Samaria would never have become a part of the Holy Land.
Yes, sir. Amen. Amen.
The Jews and the Gentiles would have never gotten together, but Jesus went through Samaria.
Preach it, preach it.
And the scripture says that he came to Jacob's well.
Yeah.
You know, before I talk about Jacob's well, I want to remind
you. Okay.
That we all well did.
Yes, sir.
And we need to watch.
Lord, have mercy.
What kind of well?
We dig.
We're digging in the Lord.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Because somebody is going to come behind you and drink from your well.
Lord, have mercy.
When Jacob dug that well, he didn't have any idea that one day Jesus was coming by his well.
Yes, sir.
And the scripture says that where two or three are gathered together, there he's in the midst of them also.
Yeah.
So, when you well dig it, if you dig a well of hatred, somebody's going to drink from it.
Yes, sir.
Lord have mercy.
If you dig a well of division, somebody's going to drink
from it. Somebody's going to drink from it.
If we dig a well of ungratefulness towards the others that work with us in the church,
yes, sir.
Somebody's going to drink from it.
Somebody's going to drink from it.
So we need to be careful while we are well digging. And you know, Jacob's well is one of the most visited places in all the world. You know why? Because Jesus came by his will.
Yeah.
And many folk will travel thousands of miles just to get to the place where Jesus came and drank from Jacob's well.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, the disciples, they had gone into town. They They had took time off to go get something to eat.
That's right.
And when they got back, Jesus was talking to this lady.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of the disciples helping, they wonder what he's doing talking to her.
Yes, sir.
Don't you know this woman's reputation? She had to come to draw water by herself. None of the other ladies in the city would even go to draw water with her.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus spoke to this lady with love.
Come on, Brother Davis.
He spoke to her with a commitment.
Yes, sir.
To what God had sent him in this world to do.
Yes, sir.
And you know, I hear a lot of folk in the church today.
Yes.
They can't understand why the church is so small.
Come on, preacher.
Well, if you leave out of here with the right thing on your lips,
yes, sir,
the church will grow.
Yeah. Amen. Yes, sir.
But when you leave out of here with the story of the preacher on your lips, the story of one of the leaders on your lips,
Lord have mercy,
the wonderful shall we come.
All right, preacher.
Well, somebody say, well, preacher, what is it that we ought to tell?
Come on, preacher. I see it. I see it.
We ought to be telling what Isaiah told.
Yeah.
You remember Isaiah said that it shall come to pass.
Come on, preacher.
In the last days, that the mountains of the Lord's
house shall be established.
Shall be established.
Come on, preacher.
On the top of the mountain.
Yes, sir.
All nations.
Yeah.
Shall flow to it.
Yes.
Now, if you want to tell something, tell it.
Tell it. Yes, sir.
In Daniel 2 and verse 44.
Yes, sir. In the day.
Jesus.
Yeah.
The prophet began to talk about the kingdom of Christ.
Yes.
In the days
of these kings.
King,
come on, preacher.
Shall the Lord God set up
the kingdom,
which shall never be destroyed.
It shall not be left to other people.
But it shall break
in pieces. Yes, sir.
Through all of the other kingdoms. Why don't you tell it?
Tell it!
Jesus said in Matthew, upon this rock,
tell it. I like that preaching.
My church.
Yeah.
And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Why don't you tell it?
Won't you tell it? Yes,
you
sir.
To tell
yeah.
Here,
yes, sir.
Get our minds together.
Yes,
and
sir.
In the right place.
Amen.
You ought to tell what Paul told in Romans 1 and verse 6.
Yes.
I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
For it. The power of God.
It.
Under salvation. Don't we tell it?
Tell it.
You ought to tell it for the Levite.
Come on, Brother Davis.
Remember Paul said in Ephesians, the 5th chapter.
Yes, sir.
Love your wives even as Christ also
loved
the church.
And gave himself.
And gave himself
for it.
For it.
Come on, preacher.
That he might sanctify and cleanse
it. Yes, sir.
With the washing of
the water by the word.
The blood.
Yes, sir.
That he might present it unto himself.
That's right.
A clean church.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
If we, as Christians, would just remember two things tonight.
Amen. Amen.
Number one, we are all well diggers.
Yes, sir.
Amen. I'm digging a well.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
Brother Thomas digging a
yes.
well.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Brother Baptist.
Yeah.
A well digger.
Yes, sir.
And we need to watch what we dig.
Ah. Uh-huh.
Because somebody's going to come by and drink from the well.
Amen.
Amen.
And we need to remember it.
Yeah.
The gospel of Jesus Christ is the power of God unto salvation.
Amen.
If you're in this audience tonight, I'm not going to keep you long. We want you to hear the gospel.
Yes, sir.
That was the most important point that Jesus brought out to this woman, by the way. And look at her reaction. You ever heard folks say they've been in the church 10 years? When I learn enough, I'm going to go on and start teaching other people. Here is a woman who heard it.
It.
Only one time.
One time, preacher.
It didn't take her 20, 10 years of Sundays.
That's it.
She only heard it one time.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says she got so excited.
Yeah.
We ought to get excited about the gospel.
Yes, sir.
She got so excited, she left her water pot.
Amen.
Ran up in the city.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And told everybody, come on and meet somebody.
Yes, sir.
That can tell you everything you ever
yes,
see.
Yes.
A lot of folks might not want to go along with that. Jesus was a preacher that believed in telling it like he is.
Yes.
He didn't hold any punches back. And so when the city heard about Jesus from a woman who had only heard it one time, they all went down.
Yes, sir.
Because they needed to meet Jesus.
Yes, sir.
I tell you, if you're in this audience tonight, and you haven't been buried with Christ in the watery grave of baptism, you need to come.
Yes, sir. Amen.
You need to believe. Repent.
Yes, sir.
Confess. Make that journey down into the pool.
Amen.
And you remember the Ethiopian eunuch when he came up out of the water.
That's right.
He went on his way.
Rejoice.
Rejoice. You can rejoice tonight. You
yes, sir.
Because you can turn your back. You can close the door.
Yes, sir.
On the life behind you.
Mm-hmm.
and come on and walk with Jesus.
Walk with Jesus.
And he'll make you a new person.
Yes, sir.
Or if you're here tonight and you've been a member of the church for a long time, you know you haven't been supported like you should.
Oh, yeah.
You need to come tonight. Get it straight.
Yeah.
Get God before we have to leave this earth.
Yes, sir.
We're going to ask our song leader, if you would.
Yes, sir.
Get us a song, and we're going to be singing. And while we are singing,
yes, sir,
to ask the church to stand.
Amen.
And for those who need to heed the call, will you come tonight?
Amen.
As we sing together.
Amen. Amen. Just as I am. Just as I am, thou art feeble, there thy blood washeth upon me. Come to thee, O Lamb of God.